guys, this is going to be the first video in a long string of videos about that big stack of records, those crates that I got. Some parameters about this, just so you guys know. First off, I'm going to be pulling, we're going to have records that are pulled out of there, and then what's available. Here is what I've decided. It's the holiday season. I want to give. If you're a member of my channel and you are a subscriber and you've been a subscriber for, you know, a little while, you didn't just subscribe today. I know who you are. I got that YouTube thing. I can see who my subscribers are. I know who every one of you is. I know you. Oh, and you. I see you over there. Yeah, I know who you are. So don't try to get some free records just by subscribing at the last minute. Second parameter. If you've ever sent me VCLT, you can actually pick out two records. Now, here's what I want to say about them. There are some good records in there from some good bands, some rare records, but the person that gave these to me is a businessman. So trust me when I say, even if the cover looks good, then the record looks like crap. And if the cover looks like crap, maybe the record's good or still is crap also. That's going to be the wants, the things you're like, oh, look at that. I want that. And they're like, oh, yeah, this is not crispy at all. This is pretty scratched up. But there are a lot of records that are not popular records that just might toot your horn and squinkle your fancy. Squinkle. I just made up a word. I don't know what it means. It sounds good, doesn't it? It squinkles your fancy. And there's a lot of them of not mainstream artists or not number one hits that are really, there's a lot of them in shrink wrap still in good shape. They're out for the grabs. So look out for those. But if you see any record, no matter what, and you're interested in, find something to do, kid. You're freaking in the shot. Be somewhere.
I'll just watch the freaking crime show Mama's watching.
Yeah, watch the crime show. Anywho, if you want to know more about the record, I'm not just going to send it to you. You can hit me up on Facebook. If you have it, let me know. If not, in the comments, I'll give you my Facebook page. And I will take pictures of the record so that you can actually make a decision if you really want it or not. It could be very well that you're like, oh, I'm getting a gift. I got to pick something out. You don't have to. If none of these are up to your parameters or artists you really like, I have no problems keeping them. Okay? Just keep that in mind. I did pull early some really bizarre ones I wanted to show you right off the bat. First one here. Check this out. There's this brand new thing that just came out called Stereo. Yes, this is one of the very first demonstration test records for stereo equipment. Look at that. This is pretty cool, and it's in good shape, but it's not something he could sell because who's going to buy that? But that is rare and awesome. Proud to have that. Isn't that neat? Found that. That was kind of weird. Next one. Oh, this is good. Deco Disco from Camp Galore. Hits that were written when your songs were your mother were around. And look at this. She's a black girl wearing a white girl vest, and you can see her boobies and nipples. What the hell? And he's like, hey, girl. Look at the drawing. That art is horrible. The most exciting disco sound since the invention of the phonograph. Wee. You're not getting this. This one's mine. No clue, but it's mine. Next up on the bazaar, there's levels of bazaar. First off, surfing Hootenanny. Hootenanny, what's that guy doing anything? And then on the back is the surfing Hootenanny game. Okay, we're getting bizarre. And what's even better? Check this out. It's old and on this greenish blue colored vinyl. What in the heck? Yeah, it's kind of scratched up, but I'm not letting that go. A board game, surfing Hootenanny. Yeah, as you can see, not in great shape, but this is awesome. And finally, this is for you guys, all you Discogs runners, all you guys with your knowledge and your music. I haven't looked this up, and I'm not going to. I'm going to let my knowledge come from you. So if you want to copy and paste in the comments from Wikipedia or Discogs to educate me, you're going to teach me something. This, in a weird shrink wrap, by the way, where the shrink wrap actually goes inside the record, there is this record. And it obviously, is it Asian, Chinese maybe? And it says, Twist with the Ventures. Can you see that? And then look at this. Look at this, guys. What is this? Crazy, right? But yeah, if you want to take a look at FL1002, pretty bizarre. This was in there too. So that's just a little peek at some of the stuff. Those are the things I'm keeping because they're just too bizarre. I gotta have them and not let them go. And then a special thing about this is I yoinked these. They're mine. But you guys remember when Flash Gordon gave me those 45s? What happened? Yes, the person who doesn't like to be on our channel or show herself went and yoinked 45s before I even get them and claimed them. Well, she did the same thing. She saw things she liked and she claimed them also, many of which I really like, and came to a conclusion if she wants to yoink them and keep them, she's gonna have to show them. That's right. For her directing and starring debut, other than to pop in for a second and say hi, thanks for your things, it's Scared and Nervous and Terrified, Mrs. Value Vinyl! Everyone give her a big round of applause. Hi, Mrs. Value Vinyl, how you doing? She's nervous. She's the exact opposite of me in every way. I'm goofy, she's not. I'm boisterous, she's shy. I'm not violent. She is. I'm not getting nooky if I keep talking. Okay, anyway. So, my love, my dear of my life, there are some records that you saw that you claimed yourself. Would you like to show these lovely people the records that piqued your interest so they know more about you and what you like? Rumors. Timex Social Club, 12-inch single. Look at all these rumors surrounding me every day. Just need some time to get away from all her weird looks because she's staring at me. That she's gonna kill me in my sleep. Must not sleep too hard. What's up next? Yes, there was actually a bag on one, so it's in really good shape. Starships, Nothing Gonna Stop Us Now from the movie Mannequin. I don't need to sing it. We all know it. Yes, Baby Girl likes it too. Take her outside, kid. Next up, Olivia Newton-John. Yeah, who doesn't love Olivia? Of course, Mrs. Valley Vinyl loves Grease, and Olivia Newton-John's in there. So that got grabbed by her. And 12-inch single, would you believe it? For I'm so excited and I just can't hide it. Okay, I'm singing all the songs, but Pointer Sisters, 12-inch single, pretty good shape. Next up on Mrs. Valley Vinyl's yoink list, it's a long list, guys. Sit tight. Tina Turner, I'm your private dancer. Dancing for money. Yes, Red, it's still in the shrink. But here's the thing. Talk to her. There's two private dancers in there. Maybe if you're sweet talker, she'll keep the one and let you have the one in the shrink. I don't think so, but you can try. Never mind. That look says no. Next up, this is cool. The Fonzie's Favorites. It's just a picture of Fonzie, right? Go ahead and show it on the back. It's one of those records. It's got a display stand on the back, and it's a whole bunch of 50s doo-wop kind of music in, on the back. Go ahead and show the track list a little better. Look at that. Happy Days, Fonzie. Okay. Next up, you'll be like, ooh, I thought you said there's no good record. Again, the record's not in good shape, but we're going to get it going, but she took it. The universally panned technical Ecstasy, the last record of Sabbath with Ozzy, if I remember right. She grabbed that because, well, it's Sabbath.
Black Sabbath.
It's Black Sabbath, right. In rough shape, but we don't have a copy of it, and she wanted it. AC/DC's Back in Black. And if you turn it around, you'll see that The cover is pretty rough, and the disc is about as rough.
Like I told you, that doesn't matter.
I know, it doesn't.
They all mean something to me.
Madonna, her debut album on here, of course, is Lucky Star, Borderline, Holiday. Shoot, can't go wrong with that at all. That's a great grab. I would have grabbed it, but she did already, and she wins. She trumps me. Next up, another 12-inch single. Paula Abdul, what song is that? Straight Up Now, tell me, do you really want to love me forever? Ow, ow, ow. Yes, Paula Abdul, 12-inch single. Come on, speed up, ain't all day, we're 10 minutes. Come on, let's go. We're not organizing them now. It's a little late for that. Oh, Jiminy Christmas.
I'm not organizing.
All right.
I'm doing the ones that mean something to me first.
Kenny Rogers, Gambler, actually in really, really good shape. I think that he didn't want to sell this one because it's another one of those, who goes to a record store to buy Kenny Rogers? Not worth my time and effort. It might be worth $2-3 to him, but he wasn't even going to... He only wanted to grab the ones where there was profit to be made off it, and he didn't think there was, it was worth the time. And look at this, guys! Belinda Carlisle! Yeah! Mad About You! Mad About You! Yeah! And show the back of that again so you can see the people that none of these are perfect. There's always something wrong with something. But for us, they're awesome! Because we're Value Vinyl, and free is worth that. Next up, Chicago, I believe 17. We'll call this 80s Chicago or soft rock Chicago or slightly yacht rocky Chicago. But when she saw the track list, she's like, I like that song. I like that song. I like that song. I'm like, fine. If I got to get rid of a Chicago album, it'll be that one. Next up, Pat Benatar. She loves Pat Benatar. Almost any songs. Fire and Ice is on this one. Fire and Ice.
It's missing one, though.
Yeah, which is the one you want?
My absolute favorite.
What song is the one you want?
Love is a Battlefield.
If you guys know which record Love is a Battlefield on, if you see it in the wild, Ms. Valentine would like it. Speaking of Belinda Carlisle, we didn't just get the 12-inch LP. We got a 12-inch single for Heaven is a Place on Earth, which I have on 45 in its original sleeve. And now we got the 12-inch. Awesome possums. Next up, look at that. More Paula Abdul. This is, It's Just the Way That You Love Me, Baby. Yeah, can't go wrong with 12-inch singles of Paula Abdul either. And still in the shrink, or not, because she's being picky. Again, she has this mental order of which order she wants to show them in. I know she wants to save one for the last because it's her holy grail. Yes, she found
this
her grail.
This is my holy grail.
She's showing her holy grail.
I actually had the tape and wore it out. Had to buy another one. I had the CD. And now I have the vinyl.
Thriller! Yes, Michael Jackson, the album that sold more copies than any other in the world. We finally got a copy of Thriller. Yes,
not
and again.
Perfect.
It's got issues.
But the record isn't too bad.
But the record isn't too bad. No, it's not. But that's not sellable and... He wasn't going to price anything he thought was less than a few bucks, like $5 or under, he wasn't going to worry about pricing them. So, cool beans.
These three, I heard bits and pieces.
So, these three are grabs
really
that she
like
had.
Them.
Atlantic Star, still on the shrink. She heard that song Freakorific. She liked it, so she grabbed the record.
But they're not from my old days.
Yeah, they're not.
So, they don't have sentimental value.
This other one, she heard the song Terry Billy, 12-inch single for Don't Lock Me Out. She grabbed that. Again, 80s pop music, dance music, pop. And finally, dum ba da dum bum bum, still sealed, not just in the shrink, never been opened, International Bad Boy Records, and bring it up here to see. There you go. It's Tony Tone with a hip-hop track that I'm not familiar with, amazingly enough. So... gonna keep that. Look at that. Okay, good enough. I am no more you can see with that. So, there we go. Simple little video. This is the first. These are the bizarre stuff I found that was really weird. And the stuff that she has. My next video is going to be the stuff that I'm pulling for myself. And then I'll start going through the rest of them, doing flips for the rest of them. And again, don't expect any holy grails in there. And if they are holy grails, there's something wrong with them. But if you want them, you can have them. Matter of fact, I'm going to pause this, and when I come back on, I'm going to show you something that's already been claimed. And so that's going to be cool, and there's at least one going out. But like I said, this one that I'm going to be showing you does not count in your free record. The person's getting it as a bonus because he's awesome, and that's Bill at the Vinylverse. He still has his pick that he's going to be able to have through the flips. He's going to get two picks because he has VCLT'd me, and I'm going to show him that. Anything you'd like to finish up with? Okay. Well, thank you very much, guys, and take a look, and this will be continued after a little click. Click! And I'm back! In reality, it's been a half hour! But to you, it was 1 second! Ain't editing awesome! So, this is the stuff going out part of the video. First one here, pazam! Jacob, out in Denmark, going out tomorrow morning. She's all shipped and ready to go. Congratulations on winning the lottery, son! Second one, packed up, ready to ship, Jesse Jane, Foreigner, on its way to you. And finally, Bill at the Vinylverse, look at this. What? Oh, damn! Yes, sir. Jethro Tull, stand up for you, sir. Coming out to you. Thank you for getting me into making videos. Thank you for sending me VCLT. Thank you for helping me with what you did to help with Sack Blabbeth. Couldn't have done it without you. And because of that, I wanted to make sure that the one record that I know is in awesome shape, in better condition than the one you got, goes to you as a bonus, as a reward, in payment for just being an awesome Bill. You're awesome, Bill. Thank you. You deserve this. Going out to you. I didn't want anyone to have a chance at that. If you don't have it, the stand-up version in your collection, you do now. So that's it, guys. First video. Next one's going to be my stack of stuff that I'm yoinking, my yoink video. And then we're going to start going through the rest. So have fun. Enjoy. This is going to be a trip. Bye. What a crazy trip it's going to be. Take care.